Hi, today we are going to discuss the topic of abnormal uterine bleeding, idiopathic. The presentation is prepared by the authors listed here. We will first give a brief introduction, including the definition, pathophysiology, and epidemiology of abnormal uterine bleeding, followed by clinical presentations, differentials, and investigations. In the later part of the presentation, we are going to talk on the management, both medical and surgical, and at last, we will talk about the follow-ups for the patients with abnormal uterine bleeding. Abnormal uterine bleeding, idiopathic, was previously termed as dysfunctional uterine bleeding, DUB. DUB is defined as any abnormal uterine bleeding with no identifiable cause. It is a diagnosis of exclusion after ruling out pregnancy and all other possible pathological causes, including genital tract pathology and systematic diseases. The pathophysiology of DUB can be anovulatory or ovulatory. Anovulation is the most common cause, where the ovaries produce estrogen but no progesterone because the corpus luteum fails to form. This results in continuous estrogen stimulation of the endometrium, causing continuous endometrial proliferation without progesterone-induced bleeding. The endometrium continues to proliferate until it outgrows its blood supply, breaks down, and sloughs off in an irregular pattern. Ovulatory DUB can be due to luteophase deficiency. Luteophase deficiency causes low progesterone levels, which results in irregular shedding off of the endometrium. DUB is a common gynecological problem. Approximately 5% of the women between the age of 30 to 49 will consult a physician each year. It is most common at the extreme ages of women's reproductive years. Most cases of dysfunctional uterine bleeding in adolescent girls occur during the first 2 years after the onset of menstruation, when their immature hypothalamic pituitary axis may fail to respond to estrogen and progesterone, resulting in anovulation. DUB affects up to 50% of perimenopausal women. In the perimenopausal period, DUB may be an early manifestation of ovarian failure causing decreased hormone levels or responsiveness to hormones, thus also leading to anovulatory cycles. In patients who are 40 years or older, the number and quality of ovarian follicles diminishes. Follicles continue to develop but do not produce enough estrogen in response to FSH to trigger ovulation. The estrogen that is produced usually results in late cycle estrogen breakthrough bleeding. Mortality and morbidity are related to blood loss. Patient can present with signs of anemia or hemorrhagic shock. Complete a thorough gynecological history. Patient with DUB may present with irregular menstrual cycles, with menstruation lasting longer than 7 days in less than 28-day or greater than 35-day cycle. The time between each menstrual cycle is variable. Intermenstrual bleeding is common. There may be spotting, heavy bleeding, or clots. Ask whether the intermenstrual bleeding correlates with the time of ovulation. Patients with polycystic ovarian syndrome will often present with signs of DUB. Obesity is associated with DUB. The patient may present with hirsutism, which is excess terminal hair in male pattern of distribution, usually found on lower abdomen, around the nipples, around the chin and upper lip, between the breast and lower back. Acne is also commonly associated with hirsutism. Patients with DUB may have tenderness and dryness of the vagina. Severe blood loss can lead to signs of anemia such as pallor, fatigue, or SOB. The differentials of abnormal vaginal bleeding in a woman include pregnancy-related causes, gynecological causes, various systemic diseases, iatrogenic or medical-related causes. Dysfunctional uterine bleeding is a diagnosis of exclusion. Gynecological causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding can be further subcategorized as benign, malignant, infectious, and traumatic causes. It is beyond the scope of this lecture to discuss in detail the systemic causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding, but suffice to say that different endocrinopathies and coagulopathies may also cause abnormal vaginal bleeding. Under iatrogenic causes of bleeding, hormonal therapies such as OCPs, HRTs, and SCRMs, as well as IUD and anticoagulants, may also cause bleeding, hence the importance of taking a good medication history. As DUB is a diagnosis of exclusion, the following investigations need to be performed to find potential causes of DUB. CBC, serum ferritin coagulation profile, beta HCG, TSH, free T4, FSH, LH, E2, serum androgen if PCOS is suspected, pelvis ultrasound, pap smear, endometrial biopsy DNC hysteroscopy if the age is greater than 40 years old. Now we're going to talk about different treatment modalities currently available for the treatment of DUB. DUB is a diagnosis of exclusion. Treatment options depends on age, severity of bleeding, desire for future fertility, and presence of associated symptoms. Medical treatment for DUB can be subdivided into non-hormonal or hormonal treatments. Non-hormonal treatments include the use of NSAIDs or antifibrinolytics. NSAIDs such as mefenamic acid, naproxen can be used to reduce the levels of prostaglandins by inhibiting cyclooxygenase. Mefenamic acid has additional anti-PGE2 receptor effect. Analgesal effects provided by NSAIDs may also help alleviate the symptoms of dysmenorrhea. Another group of medication that can be used to treat DUB is antifibrinolytics. Most common side effect is nausea and vomiting. They're not shown to increase the risk of thromboembolism. There are also many hormonal treatments for DUB. Combined OCPs provide good cycle control as well as contraception. However, the use must be cautioned in early teenage because of risk of early epiphyseal arrest. Clara is indicated for treatments of heavy menstrual bleeding in women without organic pathology who desire oral contraception. Oral progesterone is another class of drugs that can be used to treat DUB. Norasterone has adverse effect on lipid metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism, and coagulation. Thus, it is advised to avoid using norasterone in patients with hypertension, diabetes, or hyperlipidemia. Dihydrogesterone does not interact with the maturation of HPO axis, thus is particularly useful in adolescent DUB. Another treatment of DUB is intrauterine progesterone releasing systems such as Mirena. It acts by preventing endometrial proliferation and consequently there is a reduction in duration and quantity of menstrual blood loss. Additional benefits of this method are its contraceptive effect, reduction in dysmenorrhea, and a possible reduction in the incidence of pelvic inflammatory diseases. Disadvantage of the IUS is that its insertion may be regarded as invasive by some, and in addition may require local anesthesia and dilatation in nulliparous and perimenopausal women. Frequent intermenstrual bleeding and spotting is likely during the first few months. Danazol is a synthetic steroid with weak androgenic properties in addition to anti-estrogenic and anti-progesterogenic activity. Its action results in endometrial atrophy and consequently reduced menstrual loss and leads to amenorrhea in many women. Androgenic side effects have led to poor patient compliance. The use of GnRH agonists is to create hypoestrogenic state and cause medical menopause. A useful application of gene Rh agonist in managing DUB is to suppress endometrial growth before endometrial ablation. Surgical intervention may be required for patients who have not responded to medical therapy. The options include endometrial ablation and hysterectomy. The caveat is that the patient should have completed their family. Endometrial ablation is an alternative to patients who do not want to undergo hysterectomy. Endometrial ablation results in the destruction of the majority of the endometrium down to the basalis layer. As such, there is little remaining endometrium for the regeneration of the functional layer. A variety of the ablation modalities are available, including laser, rollerball, hydrothermal balloon, or microwave. Hysterectomy is the definitive surgery for DUB and should be reserved for women who are refractory to all other treatments. Hysterectomy can be total, in which the uterus and cervix are removed, or subtotal, in which only the uterus is removed. Hysterectomy can be accompanied by oophorectomy. Hysterectomy can be performed abdominally, laparoscopically, or vaginally. The goal of management for DUB is to treat any acute bleeding and prevent the recurrence of bleeding. Patients should be followed up regularly to monitor the success of the therapy. At the same time, monitor for side effects of the medical or surgical therapy. Patients can keep a menstrual calendar to determine the success of the therapy. That's all for our presentation, and these are the references that we use. Thank you.